So now we will discuss about short job. As we have just seen that in long jump, which is a 3-byte instruction, which require 1 byte for an opcode and 2 bytes for the memory location where exactly we want to transfer the sequence of our program, the short jump is a 2-byte instruction. So the mnemonic used for the short jump is SJMP. This is short jump. And with the short jump, there is 1 byte for this opcode. So 1 byte for opcode, and another byte is there, that is for relative address. So 1 byte for relative address. So in this way, S jump is a 2-byte instruction. Now, what is the meaning of relative address? Relative address means address with reference to something. So what is that reference? So we will take one example. Suppose at 0000h we have our first instruction, and 0002h we are having some other instruction, 0004h we are having some other instruction. So in this way we have written some instructions, and at 0008h, at this instruction we are having SJMP. With this we are having relative address. Now we know that SJMP is a 2-byte instruction, 1 byte for SJMP opcode that will be loaded, stored at 0008H memory location, and another byte is for relative address. For this we require another memory location, that is 0009H. So 0008H and 0009H, these two locations are required for SJMP. After this, the next memory location is 000AH. Here we are having some instruction. In 000BH, we are having some instruction. Like this, we are having the instructions. Suppose 0013H, in this way, we are having the instructions. Now, our aim is, with the help of SJMP, we want to transfer the sequence of the execution of the program at some other memory location. So here we are having a relative address. So this relative address is with reference to the next instruction which is written after SJMP. So here for this particular example, after the SJMP instruction, we have written the next instruction at memory address 000A. Now relative address will be calculated with reference to 000A. Now sometimes we need to transfer the sequence or to jump forward side, right? Transfer the sequence at the forward side. And sometimes we want to transfer the sequence at the backward side. This means we want to jump at the positive direction as well as negative direction. So here we require now signed numbers to transfer the sequence in forward direction and backward direction. So this relative address, this is 1 byte. So this byte will represent signed number. So since this is an 8-bit microcontroller, so we will use here 8-bit signed number. So during the discussion of signed number, we already discussed that with an 8-bit signed number, we can represent up to plus 127 and up to minus 128. So plus 127, 0 to plus 127. So this is represented by 00H to 7FH. These are represent 0 to plus 127. 7F represents plus 127 and 00 represents 0. And here minus 1 to minus 128. Minus 1 is represented by FF. FFH represents minus 1 and 80H represents minus 128. So if we want to transfer the sequence of our program to forward direction, then we require positive numbers. If you want to transfer the sequence of a program from here to backward direction, then we require negative numbers. Now let us take one example. I want to transfer the sequence of my program to memory location 000CH. At this location we are having some instruction at 000CH. Here we are having some instruction. So what will be the relative address? What will be this byte? So when controller will execute the S jump instruction loaded at 0008H, then the value of PC will be having, after the execution of S jump, the value of PC will become 000AH. Yes. But we want to transfer the sequence at 000CH. So what we will do? Controller will, what it will do? 000CH, 000CH minus the current value of the PC. It will subtract this. What is the answer here? So answer here is C minus A. So it will give you 2. So this 2, whatever value you will get, this 2 will be your relative address. Means the current value of PC is this. With reference to this, if here in place of relative address, if I write 02H, then S jump 02H, this is the relative address, because when the value of PC will be 000A, then in that value 02 will be added. Internally it will be added by the microcontroller. So when microcontroller will add 000A with this, when it will add 2, then the answer is C000. This is the answer, and this will be loaded in PC. In program counter, 000C will be loaded. So what will happen? In place of executing this instruction, the value of PC has been changed to 000C. Therefore, the controller will execute instruction which is stored at this place. In this way, controller will skip these two instructions. These two instructions will be skipped by the controller. So in this way, for the forward jump, we can find these relative address from 00H to 7FH. So in this way, towards the forward side, maximum jump possible is only up to plus 127. Now let us assume another case. Suppose we want to transfer the sequence of our program to some address 0006H. At 0006H there is some instruction, and we want to transfer the sequence of our program here. So now what will happen? As usual, controller will execute the S jump instruction which is loaded at 0008. Then the value of PC after the execution of this instruction, it will become 0 0 0 A, 0 0 0 A. Now this is the value of PC. With the PC we have to add relative address, right? We have to add relative address in such a way so that the value of PC should become 0006, because we have to transfer the sequence from here to here. So we have to add something in A. So what we have to add? Basically we have to subtract. What is the meaning of A? A means 10. If this is 10 and we want to bring value 6, we have to bring the program counter from 0000A to 0006. You just subtract this. What is the answer? 10 minus 6 is 4. If in 000A, if we subtract 4, if we do here minus 4, then what is the answer? A minus 4. A minus 4 is 6000. So we will get this address 000C, where we want to transfer the sequence. So basically with 000A we want to with 000A we want to add minus 4. This we have to do. With 000A we want to add minus 4. How we represent minus 4? How we represent minus 4? Minus 1 is represented by FF, minus 2 by FE, minus 3 by FD, and minus 4 by FC. So minus 4 is represented by FC. So in 000A, 000A, if we add FC, because minus 4 we represent FC in 2's complement form, and we know that with the 2's complement form we directly add that number with this and we can get the result. So subtraction, when we are subtracting two numbers with the help of 2's complement method, then basically we have to add two numbers. So this is one number and this is the 2's complement. So you just add this FC here. So A minus C. A means 10 and C means A, B, C. C means 12. In 12, you just add 10. So 12, 13 means D, E, F, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So this is 6. This is 6. So A plus C is 6 with 1 carry, and F plus 1 is 0. Simply you add these two numbers, you add these two numbers, and whatever final carry is generated, that will be neglected. In 2's complement method, we know that when we are adding two numbers, then final carry will be neglected. So A plus C is 6 with carry 1, F plus 1 is 0 with 1 carry, and that carry will be neglected. So we are having 0 6, and 0 0 will be added this. So now final value of PC will be 0 0 0 6 0 0 0 6. So if the relative address, now the relative address byte will be here FC. So when we want to jump at the back side, at that time we will find the relative address negative number. When we are transferring the sequence of program to the forward side, at that time we will find the relative address or the positive numbers. And internally controller will add this relative byte with the address of the next instruction after sjump. So basically this relative byte is calculated with respect to the address of instruction which is placed just after sjump. That's why it is called as relative address. So all these addition of the relative byte, generation of the relative byte, all these things will be done internally by the assembler. Only for the programmer, we have to mention here only label. For example, label A1. So with the A1, if suppose this is A1. Now automatically the assembler will calculate the relative address for this label A1. It will check where is this label A1. A1 is here. What is the program, but what is the code memory address of this label? It is 000C. What is the next address of sjump instruction? This. So automatically it will calculate what should be the relative address. So in this way, as a programmer, we have to simply mention here label. So with the sjump, it is a 2-byte instruction, but the limitation is at the forward side we can jump with +127. At the backward we can jump with -128. Whereas in case of long jump, we can jump anywhere. We can jump anywhere between 64K memory locations. So with sjump we can save 1 byte, but with the limitation we can jump only +127 and -128. So this is about the short jump instruction. Now short jump instructions are of two types. One is unconditional jump. And another is conditional. Another is conditional. So unconditional jump means, example, SJMP. Whenever this instruction is executed by the controller, then the sequence of program will be jumped as per the label written after this. So this is unconditional. Without any condition, program sequence will be simply transferred. But here with the conditional jump, depending upon certain condition only, program sequence will change. Otherwise, program sequence will not change, and controller will execute the instruction which is written after conditional jump. It will not skip the instruction. So depending upon condition only, jump will take place. And sjump, this is your unconditional jump. This is as well as long jump. Long jump is also unconditional jump. So there are only two unconditional jumps, S jump and L jump. Whereas there are many conditional jump, and all the conditional jump are short jump only. So we will see about the conditional jump in next lecture.